Okay, good morning students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing good. Okay, now in my previous videos, you know that we have almost completed all the things. Yes or no, we have completed the chapter. Then we have completed all the exercises of the textbook. Then we have also completed the grammar topics. That was onomatopoeia and which was a grammar topic we did in the previous video. Yes, that was about the different types of sentences. Now we are going, this is the last video of this lesson and it is a very short part. I just wanted to tell you something about reading. Okay, when you want to, there are unseen passages whenever you are giving your test also. Sometime when you are giving your English exam, you must be seeing that one passage will be asked to you and you have to answer the questions. And the passage is not from any book of yours. It is not from any textbook, but it is an unseen passage. Unseen passage means it is a passage that is given out of your textbook, okay, out of your book. So unseen passage can be of any type, okay. So whenever you read an unseen passage, you have to read it very carefully, okay. You have to read it very, very carefully and then you have to answer the questions that are given below it. Understood? You have to answer the questions that are given below it. Okay, now why I am telling you about the unseen passage is because in this chapter also, in your third chapter, there is a worksheet given and it is worksheet 3.4. In that also, there is an unseen passage given to you. You have to read it many times. If you cannot understand, you must read it two or three times and you will understand it properly. So you have to read that unseen passage and you have to answer the questions. There are some question answers asked to you. So you have to write the answers to the questions given below. Okay, students. So I will be just showing you the unseen passage in the worksheet and then you have to read it on your own later on. And then you have to write the answers on your own. Okay, students. So let's see the worksheet 3.4. Students, as you all know, we are doing the 10th part and this is the 10th video and this is the last video of this lesson. Now let's see which worksheet you have to do. Okay, students, so this is the worksheet that you have to do. It is given on page number 27. Okay, students, it is given on page number 27 and the worksheet is 3.4. Can you see? The worksheet is 3.4. So now see, you can see that there is a passage given. It is a very big passage. It is not actually a passage, it is a story. It is a very good story. So you have to read it on your own, students, and then you can see behind that answers are given. See, can you see the exercises over here? See, below exercise A is given, that is answer these questions are given. So you have to write the answers. And then exercise B is also given, read this line again and answer the question. And exercise C is also given, that is also you have to give answers to the questions. Okay, so what I will be doing is, students, I will be just reading it for you and then you can practice reading on your own and you have to write the answers also on your own. Okay, so read this story about three friends who had fun in the rain. I will show you how to read. I am reading because you must learn how to read. Okay, that is why I am showing you the reading part. Okay, students, come on, let's start. It was a pleasant Sunday morning. There were clouds in the sky and a gentle breeze was blowing. Rohan, Paul and Jacob had planned a picnic in the park. Their mothers had agreed to pack them some picnic snacks. There were fresh vegetable sandwiches, fruit cake, fresh lemonade, and some cheese rolls. "Rohan, come down," called his mother. Rohan hurriedly went down. Paul and Jacob's mother said that they would be here in another 15 minutes. Said mother, "Hope you are ready." Within the next half hour, the three children were fixing up their tent in the park. They had spread out a mat inside it and put the food and drinks on it. They got out to play with their ball and after a while came and lay down.
Let's have some sandwiches, said Jacob. They were just about to help themselves to the sandwiches when they heard a sound. Plip-plop. It went slowly at first. And then plip-plop, plip-plip-plip-plip-plop. It went faster and faster. It was the sound of the raindrops on their tent. It was becoming heavier with every second. Soon it was raining cats and dogs. Wow! Let's play in the rain, Paul was quick to suggest. And lo, the children forgot everything about their hunger and started to dance and play in the rain. They cupped the raindrops into their little hands and threw water at one another. They held hands and sang merry songs. They jumped and splashed on the little puddles. And then, achoo, said one. Achoo, said the other. And achoo, said the third one too. Rohan's mother came to fetch them all in her car. She helped the dripping children gather their things and pack them. She dropped Jacob and Paul to their homes. An hour later, the three friends were sitting, cuddled up in their beds with a cup of hot chocolate each. What a wonderful day it was, thought each of them. Okay, students, so this was your story about the three children, three friends, and it is very easy. Now you have to answer these questions, and students, you have to do it on your own. Understood? Okay, students, so this was the video about your unseen passage. I just wanted to show you how to read it. And then you have to answer the questions that are given below. Okay, students? So please read it again and again and try to write the answers on your own, and you must write it with a pencil. If you are not knowing any answer, then just leave it. So when the school reopens, and then you can ask your teacher. Okay? So as possible, you can write as many answers as you can. You must write as many answers as you can. And if you are not getting it, if you are not understanding, then you just leave it. Okay, students? So this was for your practice. You must practice reading more and more. If you read more and more books, then you will understand the reading comprehensions in a better way. Understood, students? Okay, so you must cultivate a habit of reading. If you read storybooks, then you will even understand the unseen passages in a better way. The more you read, the more your English will be better, your writing skills will be better, your reading skills, your speaking skills, everything will be better. Okay, students? So, thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.